Om Bhurbhuva Svaha Tat Savitur-Varenyam Bhargo Devasya Dhimahi Dhiyo Yom Nah Prachodayat. Om Bhurbhuva Svaha Tat Savitur-Varenyam Bhargo Devasya Dhimahi Dhiyo Yom Nah Prachodayat. Om Bhurbhuva Svaha Tat Savitur-Varenyam Bhargo Devasya.
Hello everybody, my name is Dr. Irene Caesar. I'm a president and founder of the American company Wave Genome and Russian company Metacentric LLC. I'm a coachee of this section and I welcome you to this section. I would like to thank you, the organizers of BIT's World Gene Convention 2019, for inviting me to be a co-chair of this section and give a speech, remote management of biosystems by bioholography with its mastering, the wave optics of chromosomes as the only way of stopping the impending genetic collapse. This is my company. And I appeal to BIT's World Gene Convention to reject the present paradigm of genetics, which is based in its research and development upon cutting and pasting the snippets of the destroyed DNA, that is, upon the violation of the wave optics in chromosomes. My major achievement is that I am the creator of the theory, fundamental theory, the wave optics in chromosomes. The basics of this theory were created by me in the 1980s. I have created the theory of wave crystals, the crystalline structures made of wave fronts. And in 2010, I have applied this fundamental theory, basically quantum physics theory, to chromosomes. Russian biologist Irina Vladimirovna Ermakova has proven that mice which are fed with GMO soy become sterile in the second generation. 80% of food supply in the United States is GMO, and only up to 2% of Americans can afford eating organic. Moreover, all of Americans, 100%, live in the zone of transgenic contamination. The zone of transgenic contamination is a zone where the destroyed chromosomes are distributed via groundwaters, animal manure, pollen, and insects. This means that the entire US population will be totally and completely sterilized in two generations, human generations, which is 50 years. One human generation is 20 to 25 years. Thus, we can define the present state of human genome in the West as genetic collapse. In 10 years from now, due to the genetic collapse, there will be no healthy child born in the United States. Every child will be disabled, both mentally and physically. The synthetic human embryo will be offered as a solution to the genetic collapse, national sterilization. But the synthetic human embryo will only accelerate the genetic collapse. GMO baby is the major threat to national security in the United States. Monsanto is the ultimate enemy of the United States of America. Synthetic biology is based upon the principle of destructive interference when genetic components are cut and blocked by extraneous genetic material via biochemical processes or via the manipulation of base pairing. Transgenic vectors used for violating genome include bacteria, viruses, and bacterial and viral mosaicism, and also electrophoresis, which are all destructive to the genetic material. The next level of the transgenic vectors is based upon the use of target's own genetic material. Jennifer Doudna of Berkeley, author of CRISPR-Cas9, genetic engineering based upon destroying human DNA by E. coli bacteria, argues that her synthetic embryo cannot be considered a genetically modified organism because it is enhanced only with its own genetic material, which is modified. In this way, Jennifer Doudna tries to acquit herself from the curse of GMO, from the criminal judge, that she is selling to her fellow Americans harmful biological material which is carrying inside the harmful genetic vectors of cancer, bacteria, and viruses. This argument by Jennifer Doudna shows that she was not capable of grasping the RNA interference research by Andrew Fire and Craig Mellow. In 1998, Andrew Fire and Craig Mellow had discovered the RNA interference. Nobel Prize 2006. They found out that if C. elegans worm is fed with its own genetic material, the worm dies. So this shuts down completely worm's genetics, genome. Especially effective is the short double-stranded RNA given to the worm. Research by Mellow and Fire proves that RNA interference is destructive. Thus, CRISPR-Cas9 as a protocol of RNA interference is criminal. It is criminal to add to target's genome not only the extraneous genetic material, but also his, her own genetic material. It is criminal to violate wave optics in chromosomes. Cutting and pasting of any genetic snippets violates the systematic whole of the chromosome, the wave optics, as I said. RNA interference is used right now as the binary biological weapon when human RNA is tacitly added to the human food supply to shut down human genomes on the national scale. Cancer is caused not only by the extraneous contamination, but also by the failure of the intrinsic wave optics of chromosomes. Cancer pandemics is only one of the symptoms of the genetic collapse in the West, and especially in the United States. Genetic collapse will accelerate with the launch of the 5G wireless network, which is the mega electrophoresis on the national scale to destroy human DNA on the entire United States territory. To survive, the so-called developed countries in the West need to follow Russia in its total and complete ban of GMO. But this is not enough. Clearly, the science of genetics in the West is wrong. Genetics in the West should follow Russia in making the quantum leap in biology, in life sciences, and specifically in genetics. That is the application of the quantum physics to genetics. The same gene gets expressed in the functional individuals and species via metacentric chromosome and in the dysfunctional individuals and species via acrocentric chromosome. And the difference is only in the shape of the chromosome. Functionality also depends on the presence or lack of centromere and the length of telomere, so on the systematic structural function of the chromosome. The same gene in apes and humans simply has different shape. The same gene, so biochemistry is analogous or identical. In apes, it has the acrocentric shape, and in humans, it has metacentric shape. The same is true of wild horses and domesticated horses. Their biochemistry is completely identical, but the same gene in wild horses is expressed by acrocentric chromosome, and the same gene is expressed by metacentric chromosome in domesticated horses. And wild horses, they do not exhibit strength, speed, and ability to learn. And domesticated horses express the ability to learn, speed, and strength. And children with Down syndrome differ from the normal children also by the presence of extra acrocentric chromosome. This phenomenon is impossible to explain in the paradigm of the pre-quantum genetics, since it does not account for the fact that 93% of the universe is energy and only 7% particles. And these particles are also only the concentrated energy. Also, the pre-quantum genetics doesn't account for the fact that universe is contained entirely in its every matrix point. This is called the holographic principle or the quantum nonlocality. I have extended this principle to genetics and have formulated the notion of the biological quantum nonlocality or quantum bio-nonlocality. In 2012, I have formulated the implication of the holographic principle, and it says that if the universe is contained entirely in its every matrix point, this means that every matrix point is not simply different from any other matrix point, but is unique. This means that every matrix point exists in its own non-local, infinite, in space and time, parallel dimension. Pure energy, as 93% of the universe, exists as non-local, unique wave crystals, the crystalline structures made from the wave fronts. Wave crystals are based upon the processes of wave reflection, constructive and destructive wave interference, scalar wave diffraction grating, and refraction. Wave crystals are sustained by the scalar wave diffraction grating. Grating is actually a grid of waves. And scalar waves are created by the impulse coherent signal reflected upon itself and nullified in the standing scalar wave, so that the peak of the forward going wave is nullified by the trough of the same wave when it is reflected upon itself. So scalar wave does not create any signals, they nullify any signals. Coherent signal is the signal with constant frequency. Each wave crystal has its own wave optics with its own unique refraction code in the scalar wave diffraction grating. Since each wave crystal is non-local in time and space and unique, it is possible to transmit information to and from the wave crystal only via its wave optics, through its focus, the zero point. This is the term of quantum physics. Matrix point is also the term of quantum physics. If we have two copies of the same non-local wave crystal, we can transmit information instantaneously and remotely from one copy of the same non-local wave crystal to the other copy, because in the quantum non-locality they constitute one and the same thing. And the same is true of quantum bio-nonlocality. The unique and non-local wave matrices exist each in its own parallel dimension. To transmit information between two unique and non-local wave matrices, we need to use the additional structural phantom. Structural phantom is the modulation of the scalar wave diffraction grating. This modulation is the additional scaling of the refraction code. 7% of particles in relation to biology are the liquid and solid crystals in the human body described by biochemistry. 93% of processes in relation to biology are the wave processes in wave crystals, that is the wave optics in chromosomes. Because the pre-quantum biology cannot grasp the fact that biochemistry constitutes only 7% of genomic processes, it holds 98% of human genome as junk DNA. It is possible to explain the need for this 98% of DNA only from the standpoint of wave optics in genome. Chromosome is a lens for focusing the non-local and unique genetic signal. The genetic signal is holographic. It is not simply the wave. The holographic signal contains the infinite number of waves because it is non-local, in quantum non-locality. The genetic signal is the very specific wave interference, the scalar wave diffraction grating. This is the lens. Lens is the optically transparent body, which is limited by two spherical enclosures. There are two kinds of lenses, converging positive and diverging negative lenses. So our chromosomes are literally lenses that change their shape to focus either this information or that information. Depending on the shape of the lens of the chromosome, they get different kind of information. Being a lens, the chromosome operates via refraction codes analogously to a crystal in our eye. This is Joe Tlakovsky. In the beginning of the 20th century, was successfully curing cancer by the induction coils, electromagnetic induction coils. So, in the induction coil, every turn of the coil creates the scalar wave because it goes either first this way and then backwards. So when the signal goes backwards, it's precisely the scale, the creation of the scalar wave. And you see he was using a specific induction coil so that every segment of the coil represents a specific generator of the signal. So specific resonance generator, because it resonates to specific frequencies. So the coil generates the wave interference, not simply one signal, because every segment of the coil is different in size. So it resonates to a specific frequency. So the coil generates the wave interference pattern, not just one frequency. So the failure of so-called wave pharmaceuticals is based upon the failure to recognize this simple principle. So I have offered actually to create the acupuncture needles in the form of the coils. So this will greatly increase the efficacy. So this is the bell. The other generator of the form that creates the wave interference pattern as a scalar wave diffraction grating, used for centuries and millennia. Every segment of the bell also is a specific resonator, and bell is providing healing, not because it provides some frequency, vice versa. It creates the wave interference picture pattern. So here we see acrocentric chromosome and metacentric chromosome. The chromosome consists of two chromatids combined together in the X form. These chromosomes are differing by the shape. So metacentric chromosome is analogous to a well-centered and well-focused eye. And acrocentric chromosome is analogous to a farsighted eye or nearsighted eye. It is simply the half of the metacentric chromosome. So ability of chromatids to exchange information and to regenerate and replicate in general depends upon the specific geometry of wave optics in chromosome. And if this geometry is violated, the chromosome is incapable of regeneration and replication. Thus, the genetic engineering which violates this geometry leads to destruction. So wave optics is very precisely calibrated, and you cannot add any extraneous genetic material. So we can do genetic engineering only by enhancing the coherence of the wave optics in the chromosomes. So male and female gender chromosomes. The male chromosome is acrocentric and female chromosome is metacentric. That's why females are capable of giving birth. So that's why we get sterilization, because this genetic so-called engineering, right, by CRISPR-Cas9 and etc., it actually destroys the metacentric shape of chromosomes. That's why women become sterile. So children with Down syndrome, right, differ from normal children only by the failure of optical geometry of their chromosomes. So the same way as our crystals inside our eyes change their shape in order to focus on objects which are far away, on objects that are close to our eyes, the same way chromosomes also change their shape of their wave crystals to focus the non-local bioinformation that is needed at the moment. So, in other words, not just positivist, specific information, but any kind of information. So, depending on changing the shape, they can actually focus the infinite number of signals. But if the chromosome lacks the ability to center and focus, it loses the ability to connect to quantum biononlocality, this results in cell and organ degeneration. So major failure of CRISPR-Cas9 is not simply the off-site-based pairing. The major failure is the promotion of the numerical and structural abnormalities in chromosomes. And this is the list of aberrations linked to cancer, deletions, translocations, and inversions. So cancer cure, genetic enhancement, and resistance to infections lie not within CRISPR-Cas9, but vice versa in the complete abandonment of CRISPR-Cas9 and other genetic modifications based upon cutting and pasting DNA snippets. Our goal should be the recording of the intact biohograms, because soon there will be not too many of them. And specifically, the creation of the holographic embryo.
Yes.
And to create the holographic embryo, we need to use a specific technology, and my company developed a specific technology on the basis of the Bauman State Technology University in Russia, the largest, most important university in Russia of MIT level. We used laser spectrograph to create specifically the holographic signal, not the frequency, the holographic signal. We used a specific method to digitize these holograms by the same mathematicians who created the mathematic models of trajectories of the new top rocket caliber by Russians. And we used electret-based chips coded by laser on nano level to transmit this holographic signal, because electrets are the new generation chips. Right now, we are at the moment of the end of the bioelectronic era, because bioelectronics hit the limit of the size of the chip. They cannot create the smaller chips, okay? They tried to put the chips in the brain, they failed. They tried to put in the different parts of the body, they failed, because this causes cancer, violating the wave optics of our system, right? And also, electrets do not require batteries. So they are excited by big forces in physics, basically. So holographic embryo is in fact the most coherent wave crystal with the best refraction towards the zero center. This is what it is. Holographic embryo includes the generator of the form, which should be at least a coil, okay, or better, a bell, or X-shaped structures, right? Generators of the form, so-called Kozarev mirror. It is a very old research. In 1940s, Nikolai Kozarev, the most famous Russian astrophysicist, discovered the bar effect of the convex lens in the Crimean observatory. So he put yeast in the convex lens of the telescope, and he discovered the bar effect of the lens. And then he constructed specific generators of the form that were capable of creating holographic signal, because you need to create the specific physical structure that is capable of creating the scalar wave diffraction grating. And the signal to create this diffraction grating is also supposed to be specific. It should be impulse signal and coherent signal. So it should be either laser signal or light diode signal. Coherent signal. And it should be a long-lasting signal. So, and we need to control the bio systems remotely, because they are remote anyways. We exist in the paradigm of quantum biononlocality. We cannot shield ourselves from other human beings with the wall. The idea to hide on some ocean city to escape social responsibility is sheer pure idiocy. We exist, I repeat, in quantum biononlocality. We should be responsible for our biological space. Cancer is caused by depression, and depression cannot be not perceived on the conscious level, you see? If you live in totally socially depressed society, and even if you are very wealthy on some islands in the ocean, you will not be able to escape. You know, this total, complete destruction of the wave optics in your society. This is why we need to take care of the remote management of biosystems. And the best results can be expected by the signal with the best holographic quality, the non-local hologram of the embryonic stem cell. This is what my company has created on the basis of the Bauman State University in Moscow. We have created the embryonic stem cell hologram. So our goal should be the development of biohologography. wave optics, enhancement of wave optics of our systems, and the theory of wave optics and chromosomes. So let me formulate major postulates of this theory. So holographic signal needs three components. First is polarization in the integral torsion. Torsion is the other word for vortex or torus. Reflection of the linear external signal upon themselves. It is refraction of the third external signal towards the zero center or focus of the emerging hologram, aka wave crystal. Polarization emerges due to the change in the spin. In the integral torsion, torus of DNA. So there are no particles, they didn't see electrons, never would be able to see electrons. Electron is simply the change of the spin. So it goes like this and then changes the spin, again changing the spin, again changing the spin. Reflection. So because of polarization, any signal that enters the systematic wave interference picture, right, pattern, get reflected upon itself. So that the peak of the forward going wave is nullified by the trough of the same wave when it is reflected upon itself. And certain generators to form egg shapes, pipe shapes with round enclosures and spheres result in the emergence of the scalar wave diffraction grating. Why? Our bones are capable of producing stem cells in bone marrow. Because yes. Our bones are the generators of the shape similar to laser tubes, capable of nullifying any external signal, because otherwise any external signal will cause destructive wave interference or constructive wave interference, which results in the increase of the amplitude when the same wave is overlaid with itself.
One more minute.
This results in the increase of the amplitude and destruction of this specific shape. So this is the scalar wave. So we have a reflection at 90 degrees, switch of phase for 180 degrees, emergence of antiphase. And then we get the grid, refraction grid, diffraction grating. And actually leads to the creation of the zero point of focus of this crystalline structure. So that initial signal gets scaled in the phases of the scalar wave. So here we have the picture. This is how our DNA looks. This is our DNA. So DNA is the paradigmatic scalar wave. One strand goes one direction, the second strand goes the opposite direction. This is the very well-known fact. And then we get the scaling of this diffraction grating, so that we can actually modulate this diffraction grating with the any signal, any additional signal. And this additional signal, the structural phantom, creates the scaling of the diffraction grating grid.
Could you please...
Just a sec, one second. So that any external signal is only the trigger to initiate this process, while the matrix gets connected to its own non-local, unique information. And so we have this notion of the scaling. So to summarize my presentation, we need to abandon urgently the former pre-quantum paradigm in life sciences. Because right now, we are in the stage two, almost terminal stage of the genetic collapse. And according to the present situation, only the countries which didn't allow for genetically modified organisms will be able to survive, and this is Russia. All developed countries, 80% of food in the United States of America is GMO. In Argentina, 100%. All developed countries, France, Germany, England, Australia, Canada, will
not
be depopulated and sterilized.
Not Hungary.
Thank you very much. Welcome to the Quantum Leap.
Fantastic. Exceptional. Well done.